Hello everyone, we'll be drawing a fan casing, a side view, a small detail. We'll be creating layers. And before we get to the video, make sure to subscribe and leave comments, and we will get back to you as soon as possible. Type in units. Change the length position to 0 and change the angle to 1 decimal place, and insertion scale we want to change that to millimeters. Go to layer, right click, we'll create a new layer, we'll call this casing. And we'll change the color of this to magenta. And we're going to create another layer now. We'll call this detail. And we'll keep everything else the same. And lastly, we'll create the last layer. We'll call the center. Now, we're going to change the color of this to yellow. And we're also going to change the line type to center. And that's all our layers done. I'll go to view now. And go to view for configuration. Select the second option. I'll select the casing drawing first and go into the other viewport. Go to home, select line, pick up our first point and our second point, that's the first center line. Let's type in line again and draw our second center line. We will offset all the dimensions as per the drawing. So that's 450. We've got 350 going on to our left hand side. We've got 400. So from the center line going down, you've got offset 300. And lastly, 350 from the center line going up. And that's all our dimensions added. Let's zoom in. As you can see, we've got the radius positions at the radiuses. So, in order to create that, go to draw, select polygon. We'll keep four sides, select the center, and we're going to choose the hazard option, and we're going to type in 25mm. That's all the radius reference points. Now we'll go to circle, pick our first point, and that's 425 radius. Now select the second point for the second radius, that's 375, and we'll pick up the third one for the third radius, which is 325. Just to mark this drawing. As you can see, all our radiuses are cutting through the dimensions as per our drawing. Let's now tidy up all these circles and lines. Select trim. Select the lines you want to trim as well. And let's take out all the radiuses which we don't want. And we'll also check the bottom to make sure it's trimmed up properly. We'll select this and select this again. We'll trim that line and that line there. We can now remove all the dimension lines which we had offsetted, so we've got to erase. Now go to this corner here, and we'll go to this corner and see what's happening. First of all, we want to clean these corners. We'll go to fillet, type in radius and make sure it's 0. We'll select the first corner. We'll select the second corner. That's the corners done. As you can see, we need to fillet this corner with 35mm radius. So we've got to fillet again. We'll type in alpha radius and type in 35mm. We'll select the line and we'll select this radius, and that's our radius done. Let's zoom out. And we'll look at the detail here. We need to offset the casing which we've just drawn up for the 5mm wrap. So before we do that, we have to make sure everything is joined. So we'll type in P-Edit. I'll select the line. Type in Join. Select all the arcs and lines. And Enter. And that's everything joined. We've got to offset and type in 5mm, and we are going to offset inwards by 5mm. That's our 5mm wrap done. Let's tidy up these center lines. And that one. And this one too. Let's go to the drawing. We need to create this view here. Draw line first. Vertically like this. We can offset this by 242. Draw a line from here across, and we need to draw a line quadrant of this radius from here right across. We can use the trim command to trim all these corners. And we can draw a line for center line, like so. Now, go to the detail, and as you can see per the detail, we need to offset the bottom up. So go to offset, type in final, and that's as per the detail. Go to the drawing again and zoom out. We need to create this detail. So go to copy, select this, pick up our first point, the second point about there. Let's zoom in. Offset this line by formula, and we need to offset the bottom line by 5mm. We've got to fill it. Type in R, make sure that is 0. We need to create the corners. That's our first corner done. That's our second corner done. Now go to mirror. Select the midpoint of this, and that's the other side done. Now, go to line again. Select a line about there. Make sure auto is switched off. Now I'll draw the break. So I'll pick up a line about there, come up, come down, and draw another line like that. That's our break done. Now we can tidy all this up by using trim. So that's that trimmed out, this and that. So the next thing which we've got to do is use our existing casing drawing and to create this drawing here. So we'll go to edit, we'll copy with the base point, select the point, select everything which we want to copy, and enter, and that's copied. Go to edit and we go paste. That's a copy of our existing casing. The first thing which we need to do is erase the inner arcs. We don't need them. Go to the detail. And as you can see, we need to offset by mil. So offset 5mm and select the radius here and offset the outside, and we need to remove this inner radius, and that's that. Let's go back to our drawing. Let's go to the corner, see what's happening here. We need to draw a line. The line needs to be final, and we'll join the line perpendicular to the line. Let's use trim, and we'll do the same thing on this side. The reason the corners have been done in this manner is so it's easy for us to locate the flat flange. go to the drawing. We need to check what else we need to draw up. We need to draw a hole, which is 520 diameter. Go to circle. Pick up the center of the circle. Darken diameter, and that needs to be 520. Let's go back to the drawing and see what else we have to draw up. We need to draw 16 holes down to 12, and they're equally spaced on 540 down to. So the first thing we'll do is draw the circle and pick up the center and type in down to, and that needs to be 540. And pick up the circle again, pick up the intersection point here and draw the 12 diameter hole. Now, as per the drawing, we need 16 of them holes, so we'll go to polar array here, select our hole and enter, pick up the center of the circle, and under items we've got to change that to 16 holes. We'll look into our drawing and there are 16 holes shown. We'll go to close array and that are 16 holes done. Type in PR, select everything first, and we'll select all that, and we're going to put all that information there, casing first, press escape, and then let's select all the center lines. That and this center line, and also this one here. Now go to layer and change that to layer center. Press escape. Select all of this and change them into layer detail. Stay tuned for part 2.